It's a hard one to get. But I wonder if Ye Shiwen can do it. I think she's capable, don't you?
I think she is too. Alicia Coutts is in good form too. There's the world record holder in lane number 6, Olympic champion in lane number 7, the silver medalist from last Olympics in lane number 8.
So what a field.
What a field.
In fact, the silver, Coventry's had a couple of medals in this event, hasn't she? And she's got 7 Olympic medals. So here comes Hannah Marley. A little in the shade as far as the form book's concerned, but not as far as the Brits are concerned. She was pretty slow in the first leg in the butterfly this morning. Hossu's a really good freestyler. She's been and butterfly, but the middle two have been a problem for her so far.
Yeah, we just saw her in the 200 butterfly semi-final, so a big program for her. So she'll be there in the first 50, the first 100, because the backstroke is very good, as you said.
Leverins, the American, really good in the breaststroke. It's the third leg that she's been coming through in.
Yeah, she is a very good breaststroke, because she has been impressive here, 210.06, but gee. Ye Shiwen was so strong in heats and semis.
And here she is, the world record holder in the 400 IM and already the gold medalist from there. She's had a lot of attention on her over the last few days about this breakthrough and some question marks, but she seemingly has handled it well, and we'll see her response tonight in the pool.
Spends a lot of time training in the same country as this young lady's from. Ye Shiwen trains in Australia for part of her preparation. Alicia Coutts trains at the Australian Institute of Sport in Canberra.
And already a gold medalist here in the 4x1 and a bronze medalist in the 100 fly. She's been one of the really formed swimmers of the Olympics.
And this is the event she set herself for.
Ms. Cook was the world record holder. She did that when she won the world title in Rome. Doesn't look like she can win the gold medal on what we've seen so far.
No, and has never really got back to that form of 206.15. She's the Olympic champion.
Well, she was the golden girl of Beijing. 3 gold medals here, Stephanie Rice, more than any other female in Beijing. And bronze
in comes out not wearing a tracksuit, which is interesting.
And Kirsty Coventry, she chased her in Beijing and was 3rd in Athens, so they know each other oh so well and they're swimming alongside one another. Rice's problem has been the last two, the breaststroke and the freestyle.
Which is where her strength has been in the past.
Coventry, we know where she'll be strong in the backstroke. Ye Shiwen's just strong everywhere. Then. She's been the 2nd fastest out of the semi-finals in each of the 4 disciplines.
She spent some time training with Soon Young, with Dennis Cottrell on the Gold Coast in Australia last year. Prepared there until about November when she went home. And Alicia Coutts is in the form of her life at this competition.
Rice has the 2nd fastest time ever at 2.703, but she hasn't shown the form to approach that yet. So it's a great lineup. Big, big names here with the pedigree to match. It's the final of the women's 200 individual medley. And the overwhelming favourite is a 16-year-old from China in lane 4. So the butterfly to lead them off in the 200 IM. Hannah Marley of Great Britain in 1, and then Hossu Hungary 2. Leverins USA 3, Ye Shiwen China 4, Coutts Australia 5, Cookors of USA in 6, Rice Australia 7, and in lane 8 Coventry.
Rice is off to a good start, so too the bronze medalist in the 100 butterfly here, Alicia Coutts. But Ye Shiwen is never too far away. Leverins is off to a nice start as well, so about to go into the backstroke.
So who turns first? It's Rice in front of Leverins and Coutts. So that's a great start for the defending Olympic champion. And she's a pretty good backstroker, Rice. She's getting out of the water very well. There was Coutts.
Not too far off her Olympic winning split from 2008 in Beijing. Coventry will start to work her way through in lane number 8. She's a little bit off the pace at the moment. But Ariana Cooper is the world record holder. Nothing in it at all.
So Ye Shiwen at the moment. We know how strong she is at the back end, but she's having a real battle here. So here's the turn, though, now moving up Ye Shiwen, and she quickly moves up and takes a narrow lead from Rice. The time 60.83, Coventry turned in 3rd, into the breaststroke. And getting a really good breaststroke there was Cookors.
Leverins has had a good turn too, from backstroke to breaststroke, so she's there in lane number 3. Not a lot of time for the long glide. That's Hannah Miley travelling with there underwater. But they're into really nice work in this breaststroke, and it seems as though it's Leverins. Look at this gap she's putting in, but we know what Ye Shiwen's freestyle is like.
It's a good gap. We know that Leverins is strong in the breaststroke. She's needed this gap. How big is it? We're about to find out. It's 0.3 to Coutts, 0.31 to Ye Shiwen. You think the 16-year-old is close enough to win. She's been so strong. Coots is a good freestyler.
Coots has gone with her, and that is a fantastic effort. Coots might end up be the spoiler. Last 25.
Ye Shiwen looks strong, though. She's got up alongside of her. It looks lane four just from Coots. Ye Shiwen now moving away from Alicia Coots. How fast will she be? She won't get the world record, but she gets another gold medal, an Olympic record. Coots second, and Leverance is third. A battle royale. She really earned that, didn't she?
She certainly did. 207.57, Olympic record. A great swim by Alicia Coots there. 208.15.
Tell you what, Rice
that's the best time for her as well, Coots. First time under 209.
And Rice has had a competitive swim as well, the defending champion. Not in the medals, but it was a great race. In fact, for the first time, we actually thought she might be beaten at times through this race.
I don't think Caitlin Leverance really capitalised on this lead that she had. It was 0.3 on the board when she touched, but it seemed to be a little bit more going in. So she really needed to get on that wall quicker, whip the turnaround faster. And Alicia Coots challenged for the last 45 metres of the last lap. Just couldn't get there.
So only three women have swum faster than this, an Olympic record. So Ye Shiwen, two gold medals, both the individual medleys, and Alicia Coots now with a third medal here of each colour. So the result of the women's 200 individual medley, Ye Shiwen in an Olympic record of 2.7.57, Alicia Coots in a personal best of 2.8.15, and Caitlin Leverance in 2.8.95. The defending champion went down fighting Stephanie Rice in fourth placing, and the world record holder, still that, was fifth.